Oh, yeah, that was that dude from Petersburg who died back in May or April. And his friend, too. They come through together. If you all know him, Rashawn and Jeremy from down in Petersburg, I think that Jeremy died a week before the other dude. I think they were best friends or close to it from what I've seen from them. But they come through to us, you know. We talked to this dude, Jeremy, before, back in April, late April, a couple of days after he crossed over. You know, in fact, we have a video of it, so just to let you know. Now, we haven't finished, we haven't done Sean yet, but we see him. He keeps popping through, you know. They come through together, actually. And
got a few more here. Kamel?
Yeah, we haven't done that yet, but he's been coming through for a long time. He pops in and out. I know he's from Richmond. I don't know his people or anything. But it's an unusual name, so somebody might know him.
Right.
He was the one the other day, he wanted to say happy Mother's Day to his mom from Kamel. Spelled with a K, K-A-M-E-L, I believe.
Rashad,
we've seen him before, too. That's Justin's friend, you know. Justin, you know who you are, man.
Yeah.
You know, in Powhatan, you know. This dude was from Powhatan and got killed, you know. Popped through. We haven't done a video for him, but we've seen him.
I kept a list of some of these, you know, so we can get
back to it.
Yeah, and one more is Jamal.
Jamal. Oh, yeah. That's another one we should get to.
Yeah.
You know, I think he lived in Church Hill, but I don't know. I don't know his last name, but I can see him now. But, you know, this guy has come through before. And we haven't filmed a video of saying him coming through, saying what he wants to. He just wants to say anything, but we will.
And we need to help Roderick.
Roderick. That guy has come through too. You know, see how many it is. You know, it's just so many.
There's plenty that we haven't listed.
There's more
through, but yeah.
We're gonna list them too. Put them down.
We'll keep trying to keep track of things, and if you recognize any of these names or people. Please write us. Let us know.
Do the best. Watch him. You know, if you want to talk to him, you know, call us and we'll put you in touch. You know, I think a lot of them are just as eager to talk to y'all and let y'all know that they're all right. Something we've seen recently too, in yesterday's video on Tuesdays, was Dante from that dude from Hopewell. You might have seen that on the news. He shot himself in the face and head by accident playing around with the get. So he popped through the first time, he was just flying all around, anxious and tripping on Tuesday morning, day after he died. But now, if you go back and look at yesterday's video about him, it's labeled as that. And we talk about it more. He's settled down and real happy now.
Yeah, he's getting there, yeah. He's doing his thing, you know.
And Cliff is a good one. Yeah, we filmed a video of that one too. That's another young dude who died, you know, from Southside.
So we deal with a lot of people that have died from violent death, and it just seems like that, you know, they have a harder time adjusting because it's not like they were ready to go or they saw themselves get ready to go. A lot of times, they're gone.
Some of them have a hard time. Now, Cliff adjusted. Cliff was well adjusted a couple of days after he crossed over.
Yeah,
that's when we encountered him first time, the day after he died. And,
I assume he was kind of an accepting person.
He's very happy. I like Cliff, man. Y'all probably figure out who we're talking about, people who know him.
Yeah.
But, you know, I really like him, you know. He's a cool ass dude, man. Very accepting, very laid back, and he was happy to be on the other side because he was talking about, I got all the game systems now. That's what he was laughing about. He said, I got all the game systems I want. I don't think his adopted mom or whoever was taking care of him in this physical world wanted him. People didn't really want him to play video games like that. Yeah, and you can create your own things over there, so you can have all his game systems now, which he has.
For some reason, that was definitely something that he liked doing, and he wanted those game systems.
Which reminds me of that dude from Petersburg, Ozil and shit. That's what he called him. I think the friends call him Ozil. That's what I got from him. But, you know, he's talking about that, he was wanted to say to his people, this is another guy, he was man, I'm going to keep on riding bikes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he came on through saying that, just whatever that means. And I mean, I'm not stopping riding bikes.
Yeah, yeah.
And, whatever that meant, you know. Awesome. So y'all probably can figure out, people who knew this dude, I was able to figure that out. Because I ain't stopping riding bikes, man.
Speaking of Uzzle, I want to give a shout out to Justin Uzzle and his father. Because there's some Uzzles in my family. The name reminds me of that.
That's an unusual name, man.
Yeah, Uzzle's a different name.
How many people have that name? It's different.
I
called him J. Uzzle or something like that. I heard some of his music actually on them. They had a bunch of his. He did rapping and shit. But anyway,
yeah.
We talked about Cliff, and yeah, Cliff is a cool dude, you know. Cliff is a very cool dude, and then I think, remember Lamone came through, that dude
Lamone,
Blackwell, yeah, he talking to his cousin about that he was tripping so much over the funeral and him dying.
Yeah.
And then it was
having to watch it was hard for him or something, you know, having to be there and see it, you know.
Yeah, it was hard on his cousin, but, you know, we just want to say keep your head up to his people, too. And he's all right. Believe me, he's all right.
Yeah, not that his death is not important and upsetting and all
but
that.
But be happy for him. Yeah, learn how to be happy for his new existence.
Yeah, he's trying to move on in a different world. Try to be supportive of that, too, you know.
Andrique, too, is like the Andrique is all in. Like, this is somebody that some of my friends, he's been doing him. He lived over on Broad Rock by Southgate. Well, we have a video up, I think, on YouTube, you know.
Yeah.
That dude is real cool, real well adjusted, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he came through smoking a blunt. He was sitting there chatting with us and manifested a blunt, sparked up a blunt, smoking it. You can see the smoke, loose looking smoke going out everywhere.
Yeah,
on
the other side, whatever you want, you know, boom, it's there. You know, like the video game system, the blunt, alcohol, we see people drink alcohol, party. Be serious. We've seen them do every kind of everything. I mean, it's like, it's interesting on the other side.
Let me say this. I forgot about these. Remember those ones like that, in my neighborhood where I live now, actually, where, like, those two dudes killed all those people at that house on 31st Street by my house.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think their name is Brian or something like that. They killed the kids and the whole family. They were running around on a killing spree, and then they killed their girlfriend. The dude killed his girlfriend eventually. They come through. Brian and Catherine up, I think their name is Harvey or something like that.
Family,
yeah. They came through. Yeah. Not the kids, but the adults. We were talking to them the other year.
It was the family that owned the World of Mirth downtown.
Yeah, World of Mirth. Yeah. She owned that on Cary Street.
Yeah, yeah.
But they come through.
Yeah, they're
cool. I like them.
It took me a minute to make sure I knew who you were talking about, but when you started telling
World
me
of
about
Mirth,
the
I heard
family,
that.
Yeah, I could see the wall of the birth popping in my head. I was like, okay, yeah.
And then we also talked to the girl, like, who was there when they were killed. They were killed. The girl, the girlfriend of the people doing the killing, one of those guys.
Mm-hmm.
She ended up strangling her or something, but she came through. Right after we talked to the Harvey, she popped on through too, chatted with us and stuff. And
that was a very touchy situation.
A couple years ago.
That was a very touchy situation here in Richmond and everything. And there's, you know, of course, condolences to the family and all, but they're in a better existence now.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's okay.
They moved on.
Right. It's okay for everyone else to mourn, move on. Let's accept it. You know, let's try to be
That's
happy.
Right.
Like I said, we don't. Condolences to the family. That's all I'm going to say.
And Reggie. We mentioned Reggie on this, too. Came to mind. A lot of y'all, some people have asked about him, and we talked with him, like, this is a dude, he died back on New Year's Eve down in Jackson Ward, a young dude named Reggie. You know, we spent a lot of time talking with him. He started coming through to me the very night he died. You know, it was like 4 o'clock next morning, I'm waking up, conversating with him. He needed help crossing over. We did a video of that. But we're on our 20-minute, I think, let me see where we are on time. But, you know, just, we got 1 minute. But speaking of Reggie, though, you know, like, that's a good video because Lord Buddha, Lord Christ, and Lord Krishna were all there commenting on that. And you can see how they come through helping lost spirits cross over and communicate. It might be good to learn, but Reggie, very cool dude. You know, but we just wanted to touch on a few people here. There's more. We're going to talk more in the next set of videos we do. So even more. There's a lot more people. So we just want y'all to know who's been coming through.
Peace. All right. Peace.